share if you'd like to have some sort of messages. It's also gifting. I'm going to be turning on the actual work that I do also. And so I'm going to take a moment to do that. You can watch what I do. If you have any feelings on what type of reading you want, and when it's ready to come to peer into it, then that's beautiful. I have adult knowledge. My loves. I also have to continue making. I can't stop. for your soul's expansion and liberation, like, you know, and you feel. So you have to expand beyond the ideas that there's a limited amount of things to do for what's normal or what's regular. What's normal and regular to some may definitely not be what's regular and normal to others. And when we are working with that acknowledgement, then we are then blessed with that freedom to explore who we are as beings, why we are as beings, and embracing fully the depths of our inner truths, expansively. Thank you for your presence. Bless and love. Hold on, I'm going to turn that one off. Okay. I can see you now. Love and light. Thank you.
Ooh.
shows that you have been waiting for the bringers of miracles to arrive, and we have arrived. Shows that you've been trusting and believing that solutions are on the way, but let me tell you, let us tell you, the solutions are now and here. That there's many chambers that have been open and activated to help bring about the transformations and healings into creations. Giving the moments to allow them to occur will help you to feel relief by trusting that through the patience and the calmness and the waiting, you have been able to grow part of you that strengthens your awareness that you must also be a doer, so that you are not only solely relying on source or divine loved ones to come and help you in every moment, that you are learning to also help yourselves, that you are learning to accept that you also have it in you to do work for you, on you. And that those who are coming forward to be able to be helped and worked with thee in those ways that you comprehend, the compassion that you're showing is from your experiences of surviving the experiences. When we survive our experiences, it grows such a beautiful expansion within us expansively. When we allow it to be that of a blessing and not of a victimization. When we see ourselves as victorious and not as victims, we rise up through the experiences far more shiny and less devastated. The next reminds us that we are, from the core expansions, that our truth is as if we are holding a torch, because we are walking through the places that others may not have treaded before. They were nervous, they were not ready, but we choose to come through to heal our ancestry, to heal our hearts and our souls, and to make sure that our future lineages do not continue to suffer in those ways, because we are the ancestors of our tribes. We are the cures that we have been looking for. We are the way and we are the truth, and our light is sacred. Start feeling divine. Trusting that your spirituality and connection is special. Some of you heard different things happening with different spiritual paths and beliefs because they so honored their gurus in those ways, who honestly were not in it because they wanted to be there for the ones who needed them. They wanted the money. So you have to be really careful. Who are you listening to? What messages, what guidances, angel numbers? If you see lots of numbers repeating and repeating and repeating, look at the numbers, messages. Some beings are like, oh, it's the matrix. Well, do you really believe in that kind of stuff? If you do, then look at the numbers. Identify the numbers as messages teaching you and guiding you, as if an oracle was giving you signs, you know, messages, many, many signs, many messages. A lot of messages that do work with our loved ones, our guardians, and our guides, there's numbers also. When it comes to family members and loved ones who've transformed, there's also numbers with that, especially if it's like a birthday or something like that. And it can do that on the clock, and all of a sudden you feel their presence. Acknowledging what messages are coming forward, what's happening in that exact moment that's getting to that level. Show stability, abundance, prosperity, bliss, being able to be that the expansive soul that is not just one species, but from multiple incarnations, expansions of beingness. Just speaking about our sacred dragon homes and loved ones that are dragons to another loved one who's also dragon. I forgot to ask if its pupils blink too. Shows changing your diet, changing your mind, changing the things that you had inside. So be careful what you eat, be careful what you drink. What you receive can affect the way that you feel inside. If you're eating a bunch of things that are not as supportive for your digestion and wellness, they also have them, the crystal beings coming through saying that there has to be a change in the spiritual path for more of a healing journey. So if there's strict spiritual practices that you do not agree with, say that you're saying prayers to hurt others, or prayers that those who are not on the same path would not survive, or things like that, change the focus, because I guarantee, as creator source, that it's not desired to cause devastation, pain, and suffering upon others. That's not something that is part of the destiny of creations. We're not created to suffer. So the heart healing through the spiritual practices is saying, I am loved, I am good enough, I am soy perfecto como soy, I am perfect as I am, and I am ready to be that being. Hi, Hagaman. If you give I an offering, I can do that for you, darling. And yes, I get to let you talk about soulmates. So I guess we can do that, we can open that conversation so it's an expansional conversation. I really love them. They're like in my hands. Please don't put it down yet. Okay, so the next message with this one is that there is a fertility occurring that is causing a sense of divinity from within, a rise up feeling of I have this, it's okay, I'm okay. To be able to work through the experiences in the fluidity, as you may have experienced the tower experience, which is a crumbling, which is certain pieces go bye-bye, and then other pieces come in that are super blessed and bliss and high vibe. But what you have to work with is a comprehension that you did not need those areas to be there. You did not need those friendships. You did not need those relationships in those ways to directly affect your ill fight. You have to take care of acknowledging how are you going to integrate with others, so that when the souls mates and the sacred twin, triplet, quadruple flames appear again, that we're ready for them. That we've already done that, experienced that work, and comprehended what it is that we have to do to have a healthy relationship with another loved, and working on that. You know, everyone is perfect in certain ways, and when we integrate with each other, we have to look at the positives with each other and try not to focus on the parts that are not as high vibe and acknowledge that they're working on those parts. Like, we are doing our journey, perfecting ourselves to be able to feel comfortable that we're doing exactly what we need to be doing in the moments that we are supposed to. And it is a journey, and I say it's a journey because it takes selflessness in some moments. Removing the frontal lobe thinking and activating into the full crown thinking, like where you're not just thinking, but you're feeling and you're functioning in the ways that are necessary. So it's not such of a, oh my gosh, what am I going to do? It's going to be like, ah, yes, I comprehend. And it's very easy. Thank you. Now, as for pertaining to souls mates, are ones that I see in relationships as the karmic relationships. The karmic relationships with souls mates, it can be very healing, it can be very expansional, it can be very blessed, or it can be very like an emotional roller coaster that needs to be salved, needs to be cured and healed. And when you acknowledge what it is inside of the relationship or a non-relationship, I've noticed the spiritual soulmates that I've encountered, we've chosen not to date each other and to work together as loved ohana. So we, instead of just kicking somebody to the friend zone, we're like, hey, you're my family, I'm going to keep you as my family, and we don't have to have intercourse because that's not necessary, and we have to be able to have our familyism and our connectedness in a fervent way so that it's not toppled. Thank you very much. Okay. Soulmates can fit into the category of best friends. They can, but they can also, once meeting the ones that, like, give birth to twin flames or triplet flames or quadruple flames, and giving birth to them or being birthed by one or having someone who you meet, like who are, it's a whole nother level of best friend, because the memories are more than that of a soul's mates when it comes to the twin, the triplet, and the quadruple flames. flames, the relationships hold another type of depth because there's so many similarities. When it's with the soul's mates, there's some likenesses, which is really beautiful, but there's also an acknowledgement of the multiple incarnations and the multiple realms and expansions and the essences of our soul's experiences together and how comforting that is. And that maybe we missed each other and so we would do certain things. It reminded us of the other loved one and they also did that. We meet each other and then all of a sudden it's like, I love to do the same things because we literally enjoy being a certain way because we remember those things about each other, but we don't always have to reunite to co-create children or be intimate in those ways. We can be intimate in another type of way. And it can be innocent and pure and you can keep your clothes on. You don't even have to awaken the root. You can be in the center of expansion when reintegrating together. I'm amazing. Thank you for asking. How are you, darling? I'm feeling blessed. Thank you. Okay, I'm going to continue singing. If there's any questions pertaining to soul's mates, I believe I communicated that pretty well. A lot of moments when we meet our soul's mates, which is loved ones that we've experienced before, that we are coming through in a safe place to communicate and to integrate, but also with a clarity so that it's not confused or illusioned. Because it's really easy to love each other and to get a relationship together, and I'm sure that the passion is epic, but you know that could be really beyond, not epic, but really healing. There's a song called Sexual Healing. It would be really healing to reintegrate, but it's not always necessary because you're not the same beings that you used to be. You've been through other experiences now. It's not the same. And when you acknowledge that, is when you acknowledge that the connection is transformed from what it was to what it is. And what it can be is an integration, a collaboration of friendship, of being a family, of loving each other. Oh, I'm glad that you've been spending moments with your sacred wounds, blessings. Oh, it looks really blessed. Happy birthday. I'll give you a message. Like I see it's your birthday. I'll give you a message now. It says, working with free will. Working with the free will, the integration with self-love. Love yourself, darling. And you probably can't see those activation cards. Let's see. Kind of see it now. So working with self-love and activations of the integration of free will. When we work with free will, we actually allow ourselves the freedom to feel, to be, to expand, to really consciously acknowledge what it is that we're experiencing and what has to be worked through and what must be orchestrated to help peacefulness exist within. So taking moments for you, I feel like you should be doing more regularly, getting a nice big thick sand and putting yourself into that with your feet, put some crystal beings in there, pour some salt in there, and allow yourself to feel embraced by that part of what you're supposed to integrate with. I see you with your toes in the sand, and I see the sacred waters, the Uru I call them. And so integrating that into your experiences will help you to feel like, you know, you're doing so much, but you're also being pampered and taken care of. I learned that really when I got married, I was 18 when I got married. It wasn't like a regular kind of marriage, but that I had learned how to take care of myself the way I needed to be taken care of, because I couldn't expect that someone else could possibly do exactly what I could do for myself, for me. And when we meet our twinlings and our triplet flames, those loved ones would be more likely to help. The loved ones who are loyal and too dedicated and so close can also, but it takes somebody who actually loves you so deeply and cares so deeply, expansively, to make sure that you get to have that and experience that. But if you don't have somebody there to do that, then going and getting the sand, getting the sacred suns, getting the sacred crystal beings together, or the shells, and then taking that bath and having them there also. And, you know, really working with that, because it is possible to heal with that integration. Thank you. Yes, self-love. Expansive loving. I'm going to start singing again.
Yeah.
love you too. It's really sweet. Hashem.
Thank you.
understanding those who are present. So I'm going to post one of my my music artists that I work with. Okay. so much is happening right now. There's a lot of blessings, but I'm also seeing that those who were awakened and worked really hard, being part of the purpose, part of the cause, and it's like if you ever watch football, so you're like, yeah, I got the ball, I'm running, and all of a sudden it's like, boom, and you're like, whoa, and it's like, where's the ball? So it's like that for some beings who are just now waking up into reality that everything has changed for them forever. And what has to be acknowledged is that, hey, you don't have any broken ribs from the experience. You can actually get up, and you did really, really well. And all of a sudden, somebody just hands you the ball, and you get a run with it. And they just open the whole field up, like, okay, go do that. We believe in you. Go do a touchdown, you know, or a touch up, and do a dance. Because we have to get through the experiences of the past incarnations, the present incarnation, and what we experience spiritually, psychologically, and emotionally from the experiences that happened. Because if we're not actually aware of the full lesson from that experience, then we're not truly comprehending the experience as an experience. They don't call them experiences for nothing. Did you have a dream? What was that dream? Why was it like that? Who was in it? What did the sky look like? What did it feel like? Acknowledging the details. When you got into the car, what did you do first? What did you do second? What happened when you were driving? Did you see birds? What side were they on? Were they on the left or on the right? Looking into the details, comprehending the details. Tell you what that message is also about. Look at what tree being are they on? Are they on an electrical wire? What are they sitting on? What are they standing on? Are they flying towards you or away from you? And looking at the details, leading into the details, because some of the details, they hold the keys. They hold those keys to those messages that you need in those moments. Integrating those messages with other loved ones, say you just you found someone spiritually, you remember each other, you acknowledge each other, and now you're on the journey to rediscovery. So those messages during those moments, are you thinking about each other? Are you together? Are you feeling about the other being? And what messages come forward? I pray that this has been very helpful. Yeah. So I'm going to take a moment for us to go into the deep expansions. I welcome you to inhale light through the center. Inhaling as deep as possible. Do not exhale unless you're, if you're pregnant, or if you just had surgery, or you have working with your heart to have stability and flutters. Don't do the deep, deep breath. Do little breaths of light, but I want you to take it this moment to bring in big, big light breath. Ready? Breathe in. Breathe in deeper, please. And deeper again. Not exhaling. Again, deep. And once more, deep inhale. Hold that breath in. Expand the breath as light. Expanding with sound as you exhale. Breathe in light again. Through the heart, soul center expansion. Into it again, the expansive burst. Feel the soul light shine outwards and the heart's healed. Feel the expansions in the center mohawk of light. Breathing in again, expanding. Do not exhale yet, please. Beautiful. It's really healing to do that. Thank you. Oh. Acknowledgement, appreciation. Archean. Just like those of you call it, you like to call us archangels, some of you being on that line. And we like to be called Archean. Archangels, Archean angelic light beings. Yeah, it's beautiful. So there's so many things that are happening that are showing us that we have to not get distracted. So like say that there's songs, there's music, there's things that you're hearing and listening to or watching. That's not feeding your soul, it's not feeding your heart vibes. Now you will be able to feel that with that activation, with that breath of light. It'll be like awareness, clarity, discernment of truth, expansion is guaranteed, and you're not gonna change after that. So I welcome you to do that breath again, and then I'm gonna sing in the activations if you'd like to have it lasting. Ready? For those who I'm supposed to be giving this to, those who are not, get ready. Do not, you know, that you're working through the grief healing and releasing. There'll also be prayers and light to help in that area, to help the heart heal and to work through that. For those who are consciously not ready to experience activation now, ready? Ready? And back pain relief from tensions and wings. Heal through those areas. I'm being shown the parts of you, loved ones, who needs to work through the experiences. It has to do with womb healing as well as the suffering from feeling like you were not good enough. Others, they told you you were like a shame and you just weren't worthy. They caused you to have neck and back pain, like a hunch there, like the energy looks very hunched over. And so I'm going to bring in about a light that to disintegrate some of that tightness and the shaming so that you no longer are hearing those words in your head telling you're not good enough, and you're able to raise up the spine, to align the spine, to center and expand the spine, to no longer have to work through that, oh, like not worthy, to bring in the soy perfecto como soy, the I am perfect as I am.
Washing pure two hearts.
greetings, loved one. Hi. How are you? Thank you for getting a private session with me. How can I help thee, darling loved one? Oh, you want me to take away your headache and that feeling? Okay. Let me turn the volume on that. Let's see. I'll tell you what I see after completion of that, okay? So I had to do some detachment of energies, like other loved ones. The areas that they had energy there was like, whoa. And then did some really gentle, some heart healing and some gentle healing through the crown and through the vessel. I'm so glad that you feel that. Yeah. Let's see. Oh, you're asking about your reproductive organs? You're asking about cramping. Let's see. Also, shows that you work a lot through really high sensitivity. So in your heart, it looks raw. Like it doesn't look like raw, like raw, like Ankin raw, tetanum. It looks like raw, like somebody's took like a iron shovel and scraped at the surface of your heart. And it shows that because of your experiences of sensitivity to when others are affecting your heart, that you internalize that into your organs, into your body. So even if you're bleeding, it's probably going to be a different type of blood than others might have because of the amount of energy that goes into that blood, the amount of energy that goes into your vessel, and the awareness that you also have healing abilities. You have the ability to touch somebody and tell them that they're going to be okay and that can help their heart heal through what they're working through. So you have to start doing that for you also. Let me see. Yeah. So spinach, I want you to increase the amount of spinach that you're receiving. Increase as much spinach into your diet as you possibly can. It'll help your brain, it'll help your heart, it'll help your blood. And it's really important to have that inside of your system. I see you getting more and more green. Get as much green as you can into your diet. Greens and yellows right now. Staying away from anything that's too difficult for you to digest and just increasing the amount of iron you're getting plant-based way. It shows that the hygiene of your gums also. You need to start drinking more cranberry juice to take away, because it eats away at plaque. Thankful for that information, Ellen. Thank you for teaching me that, reminding me of that. And so it eats away at plaque, which also helps the heart to function. And you want to make sure that you're cleaning your intestines, your kidneys, and the liver. Stay away from smoking inside the homes. Those you smoke in the homes, you're not supposed to be in those homes. If there's too much sage burn or too much of anything burnt inside of a closed space, you're not supposed to be around that. Like, your blood does not want that. So just being as careful as you can. Yeah, iron is, plant-based iron is great for you because your intestinal health is also what I'm looking at. And since you have such a sensitive heart, the emotions go to the intestines. So if you're increasing the iron by eating animal things and your tummy's already not digesting them properly, acknowledge that and you have to go to the plant-based sources of the iron that you need. You have to go out, you're just, okay, so let me help you then. Oh. blessed, be excited. I see a lot of positivity, lots of positivity. So experience the bliss and the bliss of being yield. It's okay, you don't have to worry. There's a song that Bob Marley sang, and it's called Three Birds. And in the song it says, don't worry about a thing, because everything is all right, it's okay. So you know, you have to pat yourself on your wings some moments and tell yourself that. Very welcome, love it, thank you. Okay, loved ones, it's about to be 1:11. Please forgive me. I need to curl into my comfortable, soft blankets and awaken to breathe healing again, to my sacred journey. Thank you. Releasing that on someone else who could technically be an innocent bystander because they honestly probably don't even have to do with that emotion and that extremity that you're feeling it inside from the past experiences that you just let get buried and buried and buried. You have to identify what it is that you have to heal through. Identify why you get so frustrated or so aggro in those moments. What is it that causes you that rage inside? What have you witnessed? What have you experienced? Who's been whispering in your ears? And are they even supposed to be there? Seeing in the details. Loving in the details. Being able to expand. Be loved, not illusion. Thank you for your presences. I'm not done with you. All right. So I'm going to take a moment to lower the volume on that so that I can check in and see which one of you would like to have a message from me. Oh my goodness. Greetings. My phone just like did a, like a movement thing. I'm like, what are you doing, my friend? Oh my goodness, she did it again. Oh, it's because my computer is plugged in, yeah. Greetings, welcome. Here we are. Did it successfully without making the phone move. Okay. Beautiful, I don't have to like pull it up on the side. Sorry for yawning. My vessel's telling me I have to go to bed soon. Alright, let's see. So you have to clear your frontal lobe from the clutter, from buildup, from different things. You have some pretty cool things in the frontal lobe, like collector stuff, like cute hobbies. But there's also the part that affected your shoulders that caused you stress when you're worried, and you don't need to worry. There's different things you do with your mouth, different things that you don't want to do anymore. That are signs that you're worrying, and you have to work through that by trusting that you're okay and encouraging yourself to be okay. Put post-it notes up, giving yourself positive affirmations to leg out when you go out the door, through doorways. Doorways is a perfect place for post-it messages to inspire wellness. And that's your message, Valori. I like the joy part too. Aww. Things usually ask, they're like, hey Faith, where's hope and joy and chastity? I'm like, I'm not telling you. yeah, it's not that I'll be like, I some moments I have those kinds of names around, but to actually meet the souls who shine that through, it's really beautiful, and it looks like you do shine through a joyous presence, so it's definitely a worthy name to have in there. It's beautiful. Thank you, Jane. Jane, I shall also see. Pray. To have an answer. Some guidance. Oh, what a beautiful heart and soul. Oh, you're a lovely expansion into creations also. Very healing light. Let's see. You have a presence that reminds me of one of our loved ones from our heavens, from like the sacred temples with the large wings and peaceful presence. It shows that you're working through. You cannot be around smoke too. There's a couple of you in here, there's a bunch of you actually are not allowed to be around smoke. That you have to work on speaking the truth. Speaking the truth from your heart and releasing the pain of the deceptions, the Decepticons and the illusioners who told you things but they also took from you and your heart got hurt. It's as if somebody jabbed like something right directly through your heart. And you have to be healed from that. Ooh. It wasn't intentional. I'm speaking to your soul. And to your heart also. Bringing in the activations. Feel that loving. To help the heart. Welcome. Happy to help thee. Love thee also. Thank you, Ellen. Layla shows esophagus, your esophagus. Shows your diet is changing. You can't eat the same kinds of things you used to eat, which shows that you're activating as part of a Palladian Starseed Light Tribe, Ohana. It's really important to acknowledge that we can't continue to poison or toxify our vessels. So you're being shown that your esophagus, it looks like it's a bit inflamed, like it's very wide. So you need to make sure that if you're going to have a nourishment that you do it in certain amounts. So you're not like starving and then all of a sudden you like binge eat or you just like nourish a lot. And then there's like that in between your tummy's like, what's going on? Don't worry, I do that also. I don't always eat. I have to make myself nourish in certain moments so that my vessel's like, okay, there's like a regularity to that. And it's not like once a day and it's like a massive meal, which I can do because I'm vegan, but those who are not vegan, it's not as easy for your intestines to handle that kind of like, oh, surprise, there's like a huge feast and now you have to digest the whole thing. And then you go to bed and you're like wondering why you're not hungry during the day. It's because you did that while you were resting, your body was resting, and your body's like, oh, you want me to keep, you know, just kind of working through that integration and being shown that's going to be really helpful for your tummy and for your mind, because then you're not as pulled on emotions. I do see a lot of things you're working through psychologically have to do with others who are working through their diets, who are getting emotionally pulled in different directions. And it's not really that their hearts are doing that, it's that their bodies are reacting to what they're eating and what they're receiving. And psychologically, it's affected them. And emotionally, the interactions with each other and other relationships, what they're working through is aggression behaviors because they're not as patient with each other. And you have to work on being patient with each other, calm, loving, integrative. Very welcome. Being cool. Calm, peaceful. All right, my loves, I'm gonna get ready to work. I have to do video editing and posting on multiple social media websites and things like that that involve a lot of focus and concentration. And I also what I really would like to do is spiritual work to help the souls. But I have to do that too, so I'm going to be doing a bunch before bed. So if your spirit needs some help, you can reach out, you can say my name, and I will be felt, and I will consciously be aware that there is healing necessary to bring to those who are ready to receive healing and help. With no harm to I and I, are we? Okay. Asha, thank you for loving me. I love you also.